Hello, everybody. My name is Kazuyuki Motohashi. I'm a professor at University of Tokyo, researcher on innovation management. So in this video, I would like to explain the activities of my laboratory. So we are actually working on the empirical research on innovation management and policy. So there are four broad topics we are actually investigating. So one is economic analysis of science innovation. So in a sense that science innovation co-evolution. And second topic is digital platform and ecosystem strategy. And third one is innovation globalization, so which is mainly activity of the multinational corporations, and also localization, so which is entrepreneurship ecosystems such as Silicon Valley and Shenzhen. And finally, we are also working on the new indicator developments by machine learning, NLP, which is natural language processing, and also GIS, which stands for Geographical Information System Techniques. So there are three pictures below, but I'd like to explain these things one by one in more detail later. So before introducing actual research project, I would like to show you some quite broad concept in terms of our activities. So basically, which is broadly actually defined as a science of innovation for strategic implications. So in a sense that so we are of course doing a serious scientific research built on sound theory, so which is basically innovation mechanism among the players. So innovation, which stands for converting some technological development results or whatever findings into economics value added. So those process, of course, there are many players involved. Of course, private firms are important player, but also universities, public research institutions are playing a significant role. And when you look into within each organization, individual researchers are actually collaborating each other, moving across institutions. So basically, for example, like incentive for open innovation, which is a firm-to-firm collaborations or innovation talents move, which is within organization or across organization, or a more broad concept of innovation, which is a platform and ecosystem involving multiple organizations. And also, we are investigating innovation and geography. So basically, geography of innovation, which is globalization, localization, those things. And finally, we also worked on a novelty indicator. So, of course, when we try to investigate this theory, we need data and we need analytical tool. So we are actually working on research paper, patent, those bibliographic information, as well as firm level activities, financial statements, R&D, innovation, survey data, so those things. And also, the tools which we are using is, of course, econometrics. But not only this, but also we sometimes use simulation analysis and machine learning, particularly natural language process, because many cases we worked on the large amount of text information in a patent or research papers. And finally, so GIS, Geographical Information System, and some regional science tools, which we are using for basically localization of innovation, agglomeration of innovation, those type of topic. And the objective of those scientific research is, in many cases, try to come up with some concrete suggestions for policy people, as well as company people. So for, of course, the question is something like how to cope with the emerging digital economy, how to cope with the changing global environment. So those are the things which mainly are targeting at the corporate managers, so how to manage in a company in terms of technology management strategy and also globalization strategy. But also, you know, there are some topics which is what is a good practice for science and innovation industry collaboration policy. So this is for more policymakers, so which is some policy implications coming out. And also, you know, policies for facilitate digital transformation of Japan. So, you know, digital transformation is very important, you know, concept at this moment. But there are many, you know, things you have to worry about, like, you know, organizations, institutions. So many cases, so long-standing practice, business practice, whatever, law, regulations, business practices. So those will be, you know, sometimes impede for you to, you know, get some fruit out of information technology. So basically, you know, those concepts is, you know, important to, of course, not only for the company, but for the government to form up some policy. Okay. So let me explain you, you know, some research projects which we are involving one by one. So first one, under the headline of science and innovation co-evolution, is first of all, so empirical studies, we need some database. So our database is built upon the basically talent, so human capital or individual researcher base, so which is the most, you know, fine-grained basically data. So there are some data set at the human, you know, capital level, and then you know, human capital aggregated up to some organization with some company, university, and you know, after that, so there are some open innovation, which is a collaboration across firms, firm industry, you know, university industry collaborations, or you know, you can have some ecosystem which are multiple, you know, companies involved. So looking at these researchers, but also we have a whole process of innovation from science, technology, and industry. And those, you know, database is not only for Japan, but also we have some, you know, collaborative, something like comparative, I'm sorry, the analysis allow for us to do some international analysis with US and China. Okay, so under, you know, by using those kind of database, we are working on national university reform in Japan. So in Japan, so basically, you know, the 2004, about, you know, 15 years ago, there is a big institution reform in the science sector, particularly for national university. So national university became to be incorporated in a sense that like an independent entity out of a government institution. So which facilitate a lot of I would say commercialization of scientific I would say results inside university. But what happened for this commercialization, you know something like a boom to the research, you know, quality. So those are the things which you know, we are investigating. So how to balance commercialization and basic science, those kind of things. And also, you know, during this process, lots of university startup company are spinned out of the university. So what is our performance, you know, what is the impact in the local economy, the regional economy? So this is another things we are doing. And in terms of the talent, you know, individual researcher level, we are focusing on sort of crossover talents. So in the sense that, you know, same person, but involving with some activity at the company at the same time as at some public institutions like university, and focusing on the AI, you know, area. So second, you know, big theme we are doing is a digital platform and innovation ecosystem. So the first things we are doing is the digital economy and the manufacturing process comparison between Japan and Germany. So Japan and Germany has lots of commonality in a sense that manufacturing sector has some strong, both countries have a strong manufacturing sector. And there are very strong SME also, you know, have a kind of linchpin for those who make up their industrial competitiveness of both countries. But of course, digitalization, AI, IoT, you know, those kind of things change manufacturing process a lot. So how, you know, this IT change, you know, their manufacturing process, and by comparing, you know, two countries, I hope, you know, we'll try to get some you know, characteristics of Japanese system, maybe strengthness, weakness, those kind of things, as compared to Germany. So, and another things we are doing is a patent leverage strategy. So for example, like there is something called a patent commons. So which patent commons means that a private company disclose their patent to everybody for free use, basically. So of course, you know, private company to profit-making, you know, organization, you know, it's not only just giving up. Of course, there are some strategic objective for these commons, in a sense that by, you know, allowing many other companies to use their patent, but they try to build up their ecosystem. And so technological standards, I mean, there are some, you know, same type of, you know, theory we could based on. So here, so how to, you know, something like use as a patent as a leverage and to create some ecosystem. So this is, you know, one of the very, very, you know, focused area we are doing. And there are also micro analysis of ecosystem formation, something like autonomous driving field or NVIDIA case studies, so which we are just focusing on one company, one platform, and how, you know, platform company as well as ecosystem participation company, and what is their incentive to form up, and what is the management, you know, characteristics of, you know, something like a sustainable growing ecosystem formation. So let me show you some of the research output we have. So first one is technology mapping and academic patents. So so here, basically, you know, all the patent information, you know, contents, we use some text information to change to some numeric vectors and mapping into this two-dimensional space, and see how, you know, technological position each, you know, patent distributed. And not only to, you know, doing that, but we also, you know, this gray one and red one, so gray patents are owned by firm, and red patent are owned by, you know, university, so academic patents. So how these two things are interrelated to each other also, you know, could be, you know, analyzed based on those information. And this one is the change of industrial structure, industrial organization of the automotive industry, so which is very, very important industry for Japan. And so in a sense that, you know, autonomous driving level 1-2, so lower level, is still there are so-called pipeline system or supply, traditional supply chain system managed by OEM, so original equipment manufacturer, something like a Toyota Motors. But when you hire up for this, the level of autonomous driving, I think what we are going to see, of course, we don't see this one clearly yet, but a major, you know, change we are seeing at this moment is change this pipeline type organization into ecosystem organization, in a sense that not only just one company, you know, manage everything, but many, you know, different kind of companies, sometimes cooperate, but sometimes compete. So competition, so cooperation and competition mixed together. And so how to manage, you know, those kind of complicated, you know, kind of structure is a big thing in the automotive industry. So of course, you know, there are many, you know, things we could investigate under that, but under this big, you know, framework, we are trying to, you know, use, you know, analyze and how, you know, how to manage these kind of things, but also, you know, what is industrial competitiveness or policy implications out of analyzing those kind of, you know, structure. Okay, so So number three, so geography of innovation. So I termed the global and local. So global is maybe we are just we are main, you know, focusing on China, because China is a very important country for everybody, but also of course for Japan. And so China high-tech industry and catching up. For example, BAT, so which is a Baidu, Alibaba, Tencent, internet platformer in China, we're kind of comparable to the GAFA in US, which is a Google, Apple, and Facebook, and Amazon. So of course, Baidu are catching up their technological level to GAFA very much. So to what extent they are catching up? What is the implications for them to catch up? So this is, you know, one thing so we are investigating. And also, so recently, US, China have some tension in terms of a high-tech area, because China is, you know, it's kind of catching up. It's kind of in some, you know, technology field, they are reaching at a global frontier level. So very, very pretty much, you know, they are capable in some sense. So of course, what we are seeing at this moment in the world, so so-called decoupling. So China, I mean US, they are protecting their own kind of ecosystem and the technology. But what, you know, would be the good way for a Japanese company or even Japanese government to manage so-called you know, some decoupling field in terms of high-tech area. So of course, Baidu, GAFA, you know, those companies also make, you know, some significant contribution to those kind of, you know, research purpose. But also, you know, we are looking at 5G telecommunication technology or beyond, to how, you know, technological, you know, progress or evolution in this field by, you know, regional, you know, characteristics make some implications out of for our economic security, you know, policy in Japan. And second one is agglomeration of innovation activities. So this is more like a localization part. So development of entrepreneurship ecosystem at the regional level, like we can see in Shenzhen, Bangalore, and not, you know, this particular, you know, space, but in general, we are looking at the role of university in terms of formation of high-tech entrepreneurship agglomeration in some area. And finally, we have a research project for IPR and innovation catching up. So basically, we are actually working on the so-called emerging economy, like China, Thailand, and India, and how IPR reforms, such as the TRIPS compliance, WTO TRIPS rule, compliance of these countries contributed to their technological catching up to a developed economy like US, Japan, Europe. Okay, so finally, we have so-called database and analytics methodology. So our focus is try to come up with a new indicator for innovation. For example, like there are lots of patents, but which patent are more novel or creativity, high creativity? So how to come up with you know, to those indicators? So this is big, you know, things we are working on, and so behind. So we try to use a lot of, I would say, machine learning, NLP, natural language process technique. Sometimes when we create some database, we use machine learning, for example, like inventor disambiguation or database linkages. So this chart, the picture is showing that the location of innovation hub, R&D center in Southeast Asia, Thailand, Malaysia, Singapore, Vietnam, Philippines, Indonesia. So those countries. And so in IPR and technological catching up project, you know, pro patent, which is a stronger patent. So whether this contributes to the local company, you know, technological catch up. And short, you know, term answer is no, because in those, you know, catching up company, there are, you know, multinational company, they are doing a lot of R&D also. So of course, multinationals from US or Japan or Europe, so those company are, you know, relatively, you know, stronger in terms of the technological position as compared to the local company. So if IPR system is very strong, so they could prevent from imitating those local companies to the technology, right? But in a long term, of course, unless you have a strong patent system, there are no incentive to their own R&D. So in the long term, stronger patent is very important. So this picture is just simply mapping where the local company and NME have their R&D center by patent data. But we use those kind of information to see how, you know, a change in IPR system and how, you know, so change in IPR system to the pro patent system, like compliance to the WTO TRIPS, and how this, you know, related to local company competitiveness as compared to NME multinationals. And so this picture is showing that some analysis of technological convergence, so which is more like a new indicator creation type using a convolutional graph neural network of you know, semantic information of the patent. And we use actually AI and blockchain, two technologies are converging each other. So how this convergence to be measured by those new type of neural network analysis. Okay, that's all. Basically, you know, so all the, you know, the papers or whatever, you know, books, research output, you can find from my website, like here. And if you're interested in, so please feel free to write an email to me. Thank you for your listening.